Hey guys, what's up? I'm Mark, and in this channel, I talk a little bit about lifestyle, but I mostly talk about business and investments. Specifically, I've made a series of videos on how to be an Airbnb host. I've shared with you tips on which condominium developers are more likely to allow you to Airbnb your place. And I also understand that a lot of you who invested in a condo are actually not based here in the Philippines. So for this, I offer my services in partnering up. You have entrusted me to manage your place as an Airbnb. And it's been a fruitful experience having partnered up with a handful of you guys. So thank you very much. And having been in this business for a few years now, there are a few questions that often come up about furnishing your place as an Airbnb. So today in this video, this is what we'll look to cover. I am answering your three most common questions about furnishing your place and readying it to become an Airbnb. What are these three most common questions? Stick around and let's find out. Let's go! So today's video is somewhat a continuation of a previous video that I did over 2 years ago. I discussed in that video the top 5 essentials that your Airbnb must have. So if you haven't watched that, you can check that out later with the link down below. So for the first most popular question that I get asked is, should I be spending in quality appliances and branded items when furnishing my Airbnb? So again, having met some of you while you are still in the decorating process of furnishing your place, I've often come across this question. I want my place to have the best furniture, really the best appliances, best branded ones, so that they could stand the test of time. While I understand your logic here, what I do want you to know is that furnishing your place for your own personal use is a whole world of difference versus furnishing your place and accepting guests as an Airbnb. In my years of being an Airbnb host, I've seen really the best of the best and the worst of the worst of guests. I mean, there will be your good guests, your guests that really keep your place as spick and span as you want, but you also have your guests who are sloppy and neglectful enough that even if your place was furnished with the best of the best, they will still not withstand the use of some of these Airbnb guests. So my answer here is quite simple. No, I don't think you should be spending on branded, top quality items for your Airbnb. I'm not saying that you should get the cheapest items out there because those will also get ruined quite quickly. So perhaps you should be quite selective on the items that you are choosing. So this would apply to your appliances, your furniture, and other furnishings and decorative items. I would strongly recommend that you buy items on the mid-tier level. I mean, let's face it, a lot of these things at your Airbnb is actually consumable, is something that's really prone to wear and tear. And that's something that you would have to live with and reinvest in other items in the future. So for your own sake, don't spend too much on high-quality, branded items because you might just get more frustrated. Moving on to our second question. This is somewhat a follow-up question from question number one. The next question I get asked is, so what kind of furniture and furnishings should you invest in? Are there things that you should avoid? Yes, there are a few things that you can avoid so that you get less of a headache when you are managing your Airbnb. So when you are selecting your curtains, your couch, your area rug, and so on and so forth, the first thing that you should keep in mind are purchasing items that can be cleaned easily. And of course, you should be avoiding items that are hard to clean. I would steer clear of selecting anything that's too white or things that would stain easily. I would lean towards dirty white, beige, gray, light gray. So these are the things that I use in my own places because you don't want to have anything, again, that stains too easily. So this would also apply to your couch, your throw pillows. Be very selective. So in terms of fabric, I would avoid anything that's too hairy. I don't know if that's the right word. I guess this would apply also when you buy your area rug. I've seen rugs that are a little too furry. Actually, I would suggest that you don't have an area rug because it is another thing for you to clean. But if it really goes with the design, and I understand that, then I would select fabrics that are easily sweepable, harder materials, not something again as hairy or furry. I would use something that's closer to a banig or area rugs that are made of fiber. Again, my intention for you here is to have less of a headache when you're managing your place as an Airbnb. And lastly, our third question, should my place have a microwave, a coffee maker, a toaster, an air fryer? Well, going back to what I said in my previous video before, technically speaking, your place does not have to have anything that's not listed on your page. In my early days as an Airbnb host, there were actually no such thing as essentials for your Airbnb. I mean, Airbnb as a concept really started as an air mattress. It was really about people just crashing each other's places. It was an upgrade from couchsurfing.org. But since Airbnb has hit mainstream, it's done its IPO, and more people know about it, it's really a globally recognized brand. There are unfortunately a few essentials that your place must have. Again, there's nothing that requires you to have these things, but if you are listing your place with an amenity of a kitchen, you would of course need at the very least a stove, the microwave, the toaster, the coffee maker, the air fryer. I would say that these are all optional. At the very least, I think you should put a toaster there. It's the cheapest one, and this would really be a supplement to your stove. As a Philippine Airbnb host, I think one of the more key essentials is, you guessed it, having a rice cooker. I think out of everything that I mentioned, aside from a stove, that actually might be more of the essential, well, here in the Philippines anyway. So that's about it. Let me summarize. Only use appliances, furniture, and decoratives that are priced moderately. Don't go too aggressive in buying branded items and things that you might feel bad if they get ruined right away. Number two, stick to furniture that can be cleaned easily. So this is again just making your life easier. And number three, for your kitchen essentials, you really just need your stove. Everything else is optional. But again, think twice on this if you are hosting in the Philippines, because yes, you might need a rice maker. Again, if you want to partner up and have me manage your place as an Airbnb, you can use the link down below. If you've liked this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, guys, and happy Airbnb hosting!